Did you know that China built the world's first 1,000-ton girder machine? And that the country also reconstructed a bridge by jacking off entire pieces of it? Today, we're going to explore three of the most fantastic technologies from Chinese bridge construction. But before we continue, share your thoughts with us. Do you like learning about construction machines? Let us know down in the comments. As we all know, China is a powerhouse in technological development. The country increased the speed of infrastructural development in the 2016 to 2020 five-year plan by utilizing a whole range of self-developed technologies. To name a few incredible feats, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge and the Beijing-Daxing International Airport were both completed during this period. In this video, we're going to be exploring some incredible feats of Chinese engineering. However, if you want to understand why this country is so amazing at what they do, first, we need to cover the basics of bridge-building technology. Bridge construction has undergone a lot of changes throughout history, including introducing new, sturdier materials, large machinery, and more recent construction techniques. Building bridges is much easier nowadays, but bridge engineering requires accurate physics, ample resources, and meticulous planning beforehand. Some people assume that bridge construction requires a lot of technical and scientific expertise, but the basics of bridge construction are pretty simple and easy to understand once broken down into manageable chunks. Most bridge building projects follow a similar organization. Although larger projects might require specialized processes, most follow this order. First, there's the site inspection and planning. Before construction starts, planners must test the site to see how deep the soil is, how it might react to certain weights or weather conditions, and what land layout it has. Engineers use computer-aided design to picture the bridge's behavior under different scenarios before construction starts. Second part is the installation of the bridge's foundation. After the bridge design has been completed, workers do the required preparation on the site's ground and start installing the foundations. Builders dig deep piles into the ground, using concrete pillars to form the basis. Thirdly, there is the installation of piers and bridge support. Once the bases of a bridge are in place, builders work their way up, adding a pier each layer by layer until they reach the desired height. Depending on the bridge type, the supports can be made entirely out of concrete or steel, and other materials can also be used. The fourth step is the superstructure. The superstructure includes the cables, the beams, and the lattice work directly connected to the site. The engineers need to use various materials and assembly methods when installing the superstructure, ensuring the element's integrity when exposed to wind, gravity, and other natural forces. Lastly, we have the final quality and safety inspections. Crews will perform safety tests on the new construction following completion of the project to ensure that the quality standards are met. This type of testing is essential for engineers to ensure that the structural integrity of their building is there and to be able to move on to installation. Now that you know the basics of bridge building, we can head over to three incredible facts about bridge building. Number three, bridge construction over water. Is constructing a bridge over water any different from doing it on the ground? More or less. The bridges over water follow the same construction process as bridges on land. Still, there are a few extra rules and precautions to keep in mind. To build a bridge over deep water, engineers have to first create a dam and a sturdy platform by using cofferdams or lowering caissons into the water. They also might need to use piles stuck deep into the ground if the lake or riverbed is unstable. If a body of water is deep enough, it can interfere with construction. Builders might have to bring specialized equipment like floating cranes, boom bridges, and hydro platforms that can be deployed over water. With these machines, workers can perform safety inspections and work in areas that they can't access from the ground. An incredible example of this excellent use of technology in China is the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge, the longest overwater bridge in the world. I wonder how China can keep making the most incredible mega projects. Well, the answer is in the following topic, actually. I bet you learned a lot so far. To keep on watching awesome videos like this one, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. It means the world to us. Number two, China's incredible machines. Do you want to make the best infrastructure mega projects in the world? Well, then you gotta have the best machines in the world. China knows that and has made impressive advancements in this area in recent years. In 2020, the world's first 1,000-ton girder machine was put into use in Fujian. Its purpose was to help construct the Maishao Bay cross-sea bridge on the Fushao-Xiamen high-speed railway. The machine, known as Kunlun, can erect a 1,000-ton box girder spanning 40 meters. The mega machine is a product of China Railway Construction Corp, a large construction and engineering company supervised by China's State Council. Kunlun has been shown to reduce the cost of girder erection by up to 20% and speed up deployment time, providing the support and guarantees for the development of higher speed trains in the country. Another critical technology that China has developed is the Baidao Navigation Satellite System. The BDS outperforms GPS in terms of signal strength and accuracy, which better guarantees a project's safety. In 2020, China put an 18,000-ton piece of bridge onto place during the construction of an overpass. This was huge for China's bridge construction efforts. The Baidao Navigation Satellite System was used to guarantee position accuracy while rotating and docking the pier. In short, the application of BDS has also provided the country with a more efficient means to construct transportation infrastructure. Despite the pandemic, 2020 was a busy year for Chinese infrastructure, as yet another remarkable achievement was reached. China's first tunnel across the Yellow River. The massive Chinese-made shield tunneling machine drilled this tunnel in Jinan, the capital of Shandong province. The tunnel's length is 4.76 kilometers, and it contains two levels of highway and rail transit. As the country's widest shield tunnel for both rail and road transport, it serves as a shield tunnel beneath a hanging river. As the riverbed of this section of the Yellow River sits above downtown Jinan, China has been making great strides in its production of shield tunneling machines. This is due to the work of great companies like China Railway Engineering Equipment Group and China Railway Construction Heavy Industry. And with these combined efforts, China isn't just the leader in bridge building, but an essential player in construction machine technology. All other countries better watch out. 1. Bridge jacking reconstruction. Did you ever think it was possible to reconstruct a bridge by jacking up entire sections of it? Well, it turns out that everything is possible for China. In April of 2022, the country completed the largest and longest bridge reconstruction project. The Yihe Bridge is located on the Beijing Road in south of Linyi City in Shandong Province. The bridge's measurements were 1,210.72 meters by 23 meters, with a jacking height of 1,050 meters. After the project, the measurements became 1,092 meters by 52 meters. The intention behind the endeavor was, among other things, to ease the traffic between Baicheng New District and Hedong District. For the reconstruction, two new 15-meter-wide bridges were lifted on the north and the south side of the Yihe Bridge. In addition, the upper structure of the bridge was lifted by 2.57 meters. It is, without a doubt, an impressive feat. But you might be wondering, why did China do it? Beijing Road Bridge is a transportation hub that connects New Baicheng and Hedong districts. For this reason, it's important to keep it in good repair and to ensure its stability. And regular bridge jackings are necessary for that. In 2019, engineers carried out dynamic and static load tests on the Beijing Road Yihe Bridge. The tests revealed that the bridge met bearing capacity requirements and sufficient safety reserves, so no immediate action was required to take down the old bridge. Thus, the most logical and cost-efficient measure was to upgrade the bridge instead of replacing it completely. Changes had to be made so that the bridge would meet flood control requirements. For that, the minimum elevation of the bottom beam had to be 0.8 meters higher than the 100-year flood level of 72.36 meters. Because of that, the superstructure of the existing bridge was raised by 2.57 meters. Safety requirements during the construction of the bridge were also an important part of the planning. To make sure that the equipment stayed stable and that the process was safe, 19 limiters were installed on the beams, preventing vertical and horizontal displacements. Beijing Road Yihe Bridge was lifted via a different lifting process, which involved two sets of jacks being lifted synchronously underpinned by support. This method allows for the continuous lifting of the entire jacking process, ensuring efficiency and control. A PLC hydraulic synchronous control system was incorporated to ensure synchronization and structural safety. What was your favorite bridge construction technology? Let us know in the comment section below. And if you want to see more about similar projects, you can watch our video, "This Incredible Bridge Construction Technology is from the Future." Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.